I can see the car that I'm after. It's this one over the back here. He sent me pictures on the internet, so I recognise it straight away. God, look at that. It looks good, doesn't it? What a cracking looking old girl. Oh, let's get out of this weather. Oh, look at it in here. It's beautiful. You wouldn't believe this car is over 35 years old. It's nearly as old as me. And the wood is in pristine condition. It's got the original Bakelite steering wheel. Just a little bit of a clean up and it'd be ready to go. Oh, what's up with that door? That sounds terrible. That's because the bottom of the door is shut. And as I can see now, the whole seals are finished and perished through. And looking down the side of the car, you have to have a second look with these things. Oh, look, it's full of pug all the way down. That's quite nasty filler. Look, it's just falling out behind. Terrible state. Ben was honest enough to tell me as well that this car was trailered in. It looked fantastic on the pictures, but now close up, no. Right, let's go and see Ben, give him the bad news. Oh, look at this. Ben, you about?
Hello.
How you doing, mate? Mike?
Ben, how are you?
I'm good, yeah, not bad at all. I had a little sneaky look at a roller on the way in, and yeah. I don't want to waste your time, it's just not one for me. It's too sore on the bodywork, and really, I'm looking for something that's mechanically sound. I don't mind a bit of bodywork to do on it, but mechanically sound, that one's shot.
I'm not surprised. Has it got to be a Rolls?
It hasn't. No, I wouldn't mind something else, but I don't think I can afford anything else, can I?
Well, I've taken in a Bentley. It's a shocker on the body, but mechanically, it's very sound.
Is it? Can I have a look?
It's here. Have a look.
Oh, fantastic. No way. No way. Oh, Ben, you're having a laugh. I'm not gonna go anywhere near this. Look at this state of the bodywork. I've never seen anything get in this condition before. What's happened to it?
No idea. Washed with a wire brush, probably.
Probably. Look, it's a mess. I mean, can you pull that round? It's going to cost a fortune.
Yeah, we'll take a look around it. It's a straight old thing.
It is quite an honest old car, isn't it? It's all any accident damage?
No.
What's the interior like? I bet that's shot as well.
Let's have a look.
Oh, she looks just as tired inside here, doesn't she?
Well, tired maybe, but she's complete. She's not damaged, no cigarette burns.
No rips anywhere?
No rips.
Does it all work? Does everything work? Seats work, windows work?
As far as I'm aware, it's all working.
OK, you're warming me up to it. Aye, aye. What's going on here? Is it busted already?
No. We always check everything, see what works and what doesn't work before we strip the poor old girl down.
So you would break this car up and sell it for parts?
Yep, every nut and bolt.
Don't do that just yet. What have we got here?
That's some of the paperwork that's come with it. The previous owner spent about $7,000 on it.
No way.
Gearbox has been done, suspension's been done, brakes have been done.
No way. Look at this. It's had replaced both accumulator spheres, renew rear suspension gas springs. So it's had a bundle of money spent on it.
Yeah.
$7,000's worth. Yeah. Taxed.
MOT'd? Yes.
It doesn't get much better, other than probably now you've said it's had $7,000 spent on it, it's going to be the price. Am I going to be able to afford this?
If you want to tickle me a small profit, $32.50, take it away.
$32.50?
Yeah.
Can I drive it?
Yeah.
Fantastic. I'm excited. Whoa! Look at this! I'm in a Bentley! And what could have turned out to be a really bad day might turn out to be a very, very good day because I never thought I'd be behind the wheel of a Bentley Mulsanne Turbo. It's a good chance when you're on a test drive to get everything up to temperature. Make sure it all works. You only get the one go at it. Brakes are good. Steering's good. It sounds fantastic. When he said this car's had $7,000 spent on it, he wasn't lying because it just drives beautifully. When you bought one of these cars new, Bentley and Rolls Royce never told you the power output. They would just say the car is adequate. Well, let me tell you, if I was to plant my right foot in the shag pile carpet, it feels pretty adequate to me. 6.75 litres up front, sucking through a great big turbo means quick. And this car really does get down the road fast. I came here for a Rolls, not a Bentley. I never even considered I'd be able to afford one. But look at the package. More power, more refinement, a newer shape for the same money. I'm ditching the plan to get a Rolls. This boy wants a Bentley, and I want it bad. I have made my mind up. I'm going to have it. I am definitely going to buy this car. We're going to own a Bentley. Wait until Ed sees it. He's going to love me. And he's going to rate me because this car needs a heap of work. on the exterior. To pull the bodywork round is going to be tough. But the good news is he hasn't got to get his fingers greasy because all that work has been done. Now, Ben, I think he's being a bit mad. He's asked me £3,250. That sounds cheap to me, but you know what I'm like? I've got to go for a little bit more off. So I'm going to bid him £3,000, see if he'll take it. If he doesn't, at 32 and a quarter, it's mine.
How was it?
Well, you weren't lying, was you? Mechanically, this car is fantastic. It really gets down the road well. I'm really pleased about that. I'm just bothered by the amount of paintwork to do on it. Now, you say you want your £3,250.
Yeah.
It's going to cost a couple of grand to paint this, isn't it?
I'd have thought so, yeah.
A little bit of money on the interior. So, say it owes me about £5,500. What can I sell it for today?
You should get £7,000, £8,000, maybe.
So, there's a profit in it?
Should be, yeah.
But you know what I'm like? I'm a wheeler dealer, so I'm going to make you an offer. £3,000.
I was waiting for that. It's got to be worth £6,000, broken, over a period of time to me, so £3,250 it is. I don't need to take an offer.
I'm not going
to
argue, I'm having it. Down to me. The more I think about it, the more I'm happy my plan for a Rolls didn't work out. With a Bentley, you've got a driver's car. You're not in the back with a big C car. You're up front with a big fat grin on your face. On the road to the workshop, the car's got real presence. I could be a rock star, a retired record producer. No, folks, I'm just a plain old wheeler dealer. But when we finish, this car's going to be getting a few more admiring glances. Well, I've been in the car quite a while now trying to get it home, and I've taken in a mixture of A roads, B roads, motorways, and to be honest with you, every single part of the journey has just handled it with ease. I do get one little warning light keep coming up on the dashboard, and that's petrol. And if you're going to buy a car like this, get used to it, because you will be stopping to put petrol in it quite a bit. But other than that, I think we've got the bargain of a century. We are definitely, definitely going to earn money out of this baby. And we own a Bentley. I'm going to say it again. We own a Bentley Mulsanne Turbo on Wheeler Dealers. Well, I've got a 100-mile drive back to Ed's workshop, and to break up the journey, I thought I'd have a refuel, Bentley style. Now, usually, once I've bought a car, you'll find me on the side of the road at one of those chuck wagons getting myself a greasy bap. But because I bought myself the fine Bentley, I thought I'd treat myself to a picnic in the countryside. Looks like Jeeves forgot to cut the crust off my sandwich. Oh, what?
Click here to subscribe.